Today, I'm taking you behind the scenes of how I build Marble Run Tech. The Masked Marble YouTube channel features crazy marble machines built using standard GraviTrax parts in unexpected ways. In the last video, I showed you 7 Marble Run Tech mechanisms like pendulums, spinners, and a spinning marble launcher. In this video, you'll learn how to build 7 more marble mechanisms like marble music, marble launchers that gain almost a half meter of height, and rolling platforms. I'll show you even more marble tech in future videos, so subscribe now. Number 8, clock hands. For my first marble grandfather clock art, I painted one side of an O-track red, then placed it on a GraviTrax spinner, surrounded by 3 pairs of sloped transparent slow rails. I carefully routed marbles from the 3 exits of a 3D printed marble lift, timing it so marbles would hit the O-rail in sequence to spin it. Each marble moves the rail approximately 60 degrees, so it takes 6 marbles for a full rotation. I thought this was a pretty cool way of spinning the clock hands, giving it a stop and start motion somewhat resembling a ticking second hand. By the way, if you want to 3D print these clock face landing pad inserts for yourself, there's a link to the free design in the description. Number 9, platform bridges. In my first marble clock, I needed to build a platform over the pendulum, but GraviTrax base plates and platforms aren't long enough. I found I could tie 2 base plates together firmly using a clear platform. Just press the platform into the base plate holes, and you have a large platform sturdy enough to bridge the gap. Number 10, Rachet Mechanism. My second marble clock included a rotating moon dial. To build it, I took 75 green angled tiles from trampoline extensions and made an entire wheel. I held the wheel together with a rubber band around the perimeter and placed it on a marble turntable with 6 marble cannons holding the wheel in place. You'll notice the angle tiles give the wheel small detents around the edge, which we'll exploit for our ratcheting mechanism. On the rotating bearing of the adjacent marble pendulum, I taped a rail to a height stacker in just the right place to push against the wheel detents as it rotated. Angling a separate bridge piece on top of the wheel acted as a catch to prevent the wheel from moving backwards when the pendulum swung the opposite way. The result was a ratcheting motion that inched the wheel in a clockwise direction. The result wasn't perfect, but in general, it did rotate the moon dial in the clockwise direction, taking at least 75 pendulum swings to turn the moon dial completely around. Number 11, marble music. My second marble grandfather clock played the 16-note Westminster Chimes melody, followed by some hour strikes. Here's how it works. Since we have to play a 16-note melody, we first construct a grid of 15 GraviTrax switches with 16 exits, one for each note. The first row has 1 switch, the second has 2, the third has 4, and the last row has 8. Marbles roll out of the 16 exits in a predictable pattern that repeats every 16 marbles. We record the pattern the marbles exit. First marble, second marble, third marble, all the way to the 16th marble. Next to each switch, we'll write down which marbles roll to its left and which to its right. This will come in handy at the end. Now the Westminster melody only has 4 different pitches in it, Do, Fa, Sol, and La. So the next step is to match each of the 16 exits to one of those 4 pitches in the order of the melody. 3, 4, 13, 14, 15, 16. Next, we simplify the layout as much as possible by looking for switches where the same pitch or sequence of pitches is played at both its exits. In that case, we can remove the switch because it is unnecessary. We also can sometimes simplify the switch grid by looking for different switches that have an exit that plays the same pitch sequence. We can merge their exits and then remove any duplicate switches below. Lastly, we merge together all the exits that play each of the 4 pitches. Now we can build this in GraviTrax by first building the field of switches and then merging tracks together so marbles go to one of 4 tuned chimes hanging from tunnel track pieces with the tunnel part offset. After the 16th marble plays the final tone of the melody, the 17th marble changes the direction of this GraviTrax dipper switch, sending all remaining marbles on a separate path to ring the hour strikes on these large chimes. This switch needs to be reset each time after the melody is played, but the note programming switches don't need to be reset because every 16 marbles, they cycle back to their starting position. But the chimes really aren't that loud. What we really need are these GraviTrax Xylophone tiles from the Melodic Marbles Etsy store. They are so much louder. You can learn more about these tiles on the Melodic Marbles YouTube channel, where carolinist Joey Brink hit the ball out of the park by inventing the most straightforward way for anyone to make melodies with GraviTrax. Check out the Melodic Marbles Etsy store for these melodic tiles, plus a whole bunch of percussion extensions you can add to your GraviTrax builds like wind chimes, rainbow stairs, tambourine, cymbals, and a two-tone wood block. Also check out Joey's main YouTube channel where he explains why tower bells sound out of tune. For real, I had always wondered about that. Number 12, rolling platforms. An offshoot of the marble bearing, rolling platforms use marbles in straight tracks to move entire platforms instead of spinning them in a circle. Build these by starting with a clear platform balanced so it can pivot slightly from flat to angled. On top of this, place GraviTrax tiles to create two straight parallel marble channels. Just off this platform, build an angled slope of additional straight tiles and join them with the tilting platform using short rails. Add two more parallel marble channels on the bottom side of a GraviTrax base plate. With the pivoting platform laying flat, add marbles to the parallel tracks and place the base plate on top. Build your marble run on top of the rolling platform, taking care to balance the weight so that a marble or two launches the platform by causing it to tilt and roll down the slope. Have GraviTrax will travel. Number 13, Zipline Jumper Launcher. This marble launching mechanism uses zip lines and jumpers to launch a marble above. I used them extensively in my 21-minute marble run. They are constructed with a GraviTrax jumper or volcano on which is set a zip line, which at the top is threaded through the base of a GraviTrax Pro mixer on which is set a splash pad insert. A marble below triggers the jumper, pushing up on the lever, launching a marble sitting in the splash pad above. This can gain you over 20 centimeters in height. I even made this tower with 5 zipline launchers. Number 14, Zipline Lever Launcher. Make a ring out of GraviTrax bridge pieces and add 2 ziplines, one on each end. Now you have a lever that can be used to gain over 45 centimeters of height by launching marbles above. Use a lever in mousetrap mode by balancing the edge of the bridge ring on a double balcony. A marble below pushes the bridge off the platform, dropping it to release a marble that is sitting on a short Bernoulli rail. Or you can use the zipline lever in lever mode, so a marble below pushes the lever like a seesaw, launching a marble above with a push. I also used one of these with a marble turntable in my Pixel Art marble machine. You can even daisy chain these together like in my second pachinko style wall mounted marble run and gain incredible height. One cool feature of the zipline levers is that they are held captive to the balcony on which they are mounted. So when activated, they don't fall down on the track where they might block a marble below. Now take a second to bop the like button and write in the comments which marble mechanism was your favorite. Don't miss the next video where I'll show you how to make 7 more amazing marble machines like spinning platform tricks, decorative marble displays, and GraviTrax gears. Subscribe so you don't miss it.